Regrets are always at the end of a string. At the end of a very long tail.
Good morning, pa.
At the end point of a line. We are bound on making things that our first thought is right, then realize that it is not at the end. And the great pain it brings is intense as hell. Everything is normal. Everything is smoothly going through our track. But that everything changed when he came to our lives. This is a story of regrets, pain, and worries. And these started once upon a cloudy day. Fred, the leader, was president of the class. He wrote perfect things and walked with a limp. He was fond of short stories and short girls like Conchita. Conchita was a candidate for valedictorian. She knew all the rules of grammar, but somehow or other, she could not write as well as Fred.
So, Karel, do you find the meaning of lover?
There were several other brilliant students. Maria, who spoke like a debater and declaimed formulas in mathematics.
Never mind.
Javier, who was the extemporaneous speaker in class, in spite of a voice which sounded like a foghorn.
Hello,
He had the temper of a genius. Gloria, in particular, thought she was a genius. She was a young girl who believed in the power of music and the survival of democracy. And there was Zion, perpetual guardian of a perpetually empty treasury, and her ambition in life was to get rid of her shyness and her pimples. Belen. When people outside the class ask, "Where's Belen?" her classmates would answer, "On the honor roll," for she was always there, a perpetual valedictorian in a class of top-notchers.
Class, you look intelligent, all of you, but that remains to be proved. Your advisor is Mr. Arsenio Elton. That's my name. I'm Manny Lucano. Class, dismiss.
Classmates, our new teacher is an international figure. Look, he teaches English, he has Chinese eyes, he speaks with an American accent, and...
Danny Lucano. What's wrong with you guys?
Class, you look intelligent, all of you. But that remains to be proved.
Hey guys, look! Why don't we prove it?
Why not?
Mr. Torres should have been impressed, but he was not. He took the perfect lessons as quite routinary. Some of the students asked questions to him to make him embarrassed, but he answered it straightly with correct information.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
The meaning of the word supercalifragilisticexpialidocious is okay. Javier, am I right?
Okay, last dismiss.
In the villain section, there are groups. The first one is the girls' direction, who are all liked by the boys. But these girls do not only have beauty, they are also brainy.
Oh my god, he is awesome! He teaches us a poem without knowing his book!
It was evidence that Mr. Torres has mastered the subject, but he does not smile.
Yes, why you act like that?
He's bitter. Am I right?
Yes!
Guys, all of you are correct.
But there's something that's not here.
That we are all beautiful.
Yes!
The second one is the bookish group. They read books, always. Some of the class call them nerdy.
Nerdy, laughter in the class is a crime.
Didn't you feel any at the time of Mr. Torres? There was something wrong with him, but I don't know why.
But for sure for us, it was always a relief to hear the bell after 40 minutes of academic torture in the room of Torres Manuel.
Yes, I agree!
Do you agree?
Yes!
Sir!
And there is Super Junior, the group of boys. They are the heartthrobs of the campus. But they do not give importance to girls. They are much focused on studying instead of making moves for girls. Aside from the groups, there are the students in the classroom that have their own girls.
Why can't Mr. Torres be like the other teacher? Affable, pleasant, and full of humor.
I think all of us have only one topic. Mr. Torres. Right?
Yes!
Mr. Torres is not here! He's out there!
During the latter part of August, there were days when Mr. Torres did not report to class. His students were pleased. Such occasions called for celebration. Some of the students even hoped Mr. Torres would stay away from class even longer than a day at a time. That was how they felt about unpopular teachers. And Mr. Torres was very unpopular.
God, he's always
hungry.
Yeah, exactly.
Can you
Nobody noticed the change in Mr. Torres. Even the class failed to realize there was something wrong with their teacher. He had grown paler, and his lips were always tightly pressed as if he was enduring some lingering pain. Everybody thought he was working hard or was worried about his family. They heard his family had come to town, but nobody even saw his wife and children. Nobody cared.
Class!
Yes.
I forgot to tell you last week that this class is scheduled to take charge of the morning program on Monday.
What?
You have about 12 days to prepare.
But why you didn't tell us about earlier? Besides, the other session had at least 1 month to prepare. What kind of program can you put up after 12 days preparation? That's very ridiculous.
Yes!
No! Yes!
The time is sufficient. Order is sufficient. All you need is a duet, a speech, and a song by a chorus. That's all.
What's the theme, sir?
Theme is courage.
Mr. Torres, Mr. Torres, where can we get the song about courage?
Who are the best singers in class? For your opinion. Fred, you will give a talk about the courage.
Javier can do that.
I want you to do that. Why can't you do it?
Why not?
Alright, that's settled. Fred, sit down. Maria, you will take charge of the chorus. And the song you choose will do.
Okay, sir.
And on the day of the program, I want everybody to wear white. I like white.
Sir, we prefer khaki.
Okay. Here's your assignment. Copy and answer. And your English notebook, page 218 at your English expressway. Okay, class, goodbye.
Goodbye, Mr. Torres. See you tomorrow.
Our recitation. How was the practice? Is it okay, Maria?
Don't you worry, sir. Everything was all right and okay.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Oi, Maria. You missed it. Yeah. Gloria, Esther, how was your rehearsal?
We like to change.
I don't like the song, sir. It's too common.
We must have our own rights to choose what we want to sing.
I like the song, Where's the Land of Joy?
For on Sunday, the news of Mr. Torres' death spread through the town, shocking everybody.
Mr. Torres had been a sick man. He had managed to get his disease a secret from even those who knew him intimately.
Our theme this morning is courage. This program is specially dedicated to our beloved teacher and advisor, who, as you all know, passed away yesterday. He was a stranger in our midst when he came, and a stranger when he left us. We who were under him understood him firm, quiet, humorless way of doing things. We did not bother to ask why he was different, why he hurried through things in a business-like way, as if there were tomorrow. In our impulsiveness, we pronounced judgment on him, thinking he was one of those mentors whom years of teaching had hardened to love things of life. We look upon him as an automaton, but now, too late, we have learned what a martyr he was to fame. He could have smiling rather than bite his lip in agony, or stay at home and suffer. He pursued the even tenor of his teaching days without a sign of the excruciating pain that daily attacked. This is courage, my friends, the courage of a man who would rather be misunderstood than admit defeat. I'd like to tell you the stop of young guilt of a group of conceited fools who made the remaining days of our teachers not as pleasant as they should have been, but God knows.
Thank you. Uli, tumawa.
Dahil sa kapal kayo! Eh, ang dami pa natin kayo, may kundi kayo. Uy, oo, mamaya na.
Ay!
All you need is do it. Friend, you will give a talk about what?
I don't want to see the money!